R2-D2, our enemy.
Show that, Bobcat said, as the four of them sprawled on the couches in the main eating area. Is the question of the evening.
What a question, Marcus admitted. He and Tina were sharing a couch. He was thinking as Tina leaned back against him, her feet hanging over the other armrest. She was gazing at her tablet. Do we know how large the realm is? She asked.
Nope, Bobcat answered. Well, okay. I mean, we haven't measured it or anything, but if we formulate some sort of distance equivalent, it's pretty damn large. Bethanyan has used it back on Earth and in multiple systems here. Seems to be about the same distance from her perspective.
I doubt we could cause too many problems then, she replied. Imagine how much energy is available.
Yes, but we have no idea exactly where some of that energy is derived. We have good postulations, William countered. And we have Tom. Here, good point, Bobcat called. Argue, can you connect us to Tom? Moments before Tom's voice was heard through the loudspeakers. What can I do for the esteemed Team BMW? Nice save there, buddy. He chuckled. Match with you doesn't work as well, Tom replied. But if we say Team BMW Team, then you know someone will bug in eyes and say Bibbles or Bumblebutt, William. Personally, I suspect anything with bone.
Only those who know English? Tina shook her head. I doubt most know it anymore.
There's a lot of yawing spoken now, Bobcat agreed. Yes, Bob agreed to the speaker. But the Mwe Yucatan is an ancient yawing phrase for suck my grandmother's butt. Who the hell would put that out there? Bobcat shook his head. I'd rather think someone would use the English bum, not the yawing phrase.
It's okay, Tom, I said. That stuff about needing to change the name is from Cheryl Lynn. I don't really care.
Seriously? Looked down at her, his hand across her stomach. Change it. I've already talked with the guys.
I'll do a special pin or something else, son, she replied. It would be like changing the Three Musketeers.
They did that, William replied. They made a Four Musketeers.
How did you feel about it?
Not fair, William shook his head. Sorry, not falling into that trap.
I thought so, Tina replied. How about this? I'm happy being Mrs. M at the moment.
Works for me. But seriously, you can have my attention, Marcus told her.
Leave it be, honey. We are fine.
Marcus shrugged and went back to his tablet. Show Tom. Bobcat steered the conversation back on track. He wanted to know just how much energy he can draw from the etheric at one time. Why? Tom asked, puzzlement in his voice. Marcus planned on doing something large. 100,000 bits at a time, give or take 5,000, William said.
There was a long pause before Adam spoke from the speakers.
Are you suggesting you can fire 100,000 bits simultaneously?
I believe they are, Tom replied. That is a large manufacturing effort.
It is, William replied. But say we figure out how to mass produce the bits. What will happen if we have a few million in place for some insane reason? 100,000 don't.
Focus on what Bethanyan is doing now.
Same here, Tom shot back. summarize the conversation.
Okay. Sounds like the overall energy.
We need to program in a time factor for rejuvenation at the location of the etheric energy.
Bobcat nodded. We'll get those calculations from Anna. Plug a fire preference set to particular time into the chips on the bench. If they are group A, they only fire every 3 microseconds or something. If they need to fire earlier, they can. But that would help bypass the sporadic communication issue. We need a PI for each implementation. Marcus considered aloud. Something that isn't stuck in one location, but its knowledge is in the etheric, he said. He leaned forward and turned around. Why don't we get with Anne? He started to smile.
Genius.
He looked at William and raised an eyebrow.
Works for me,
William replied.
Me too, Marcus replied.
B3.
Oh, I looked at Tina.
Okay. You need to go check.
I looked at the guys. Hey, going into the etheric creeps me the hell out.
Those who come up with the best ideas,
William quoted,
are shafted by being required to work on them.
Fine, Tina leaned back. But not for at least a week.
What? William asked.
What's up with a week?
We, rubbed her thumb over her shoulder at Marcus, aren't going too far from our rooms for a week. Deal with it.
I shook his head.
Wow, bushy.
You would be too if you had been working on the same recalcitrant scientist for as long as I have.
Better make it 2.
William nodded.
Send in the information to Sishan. Maybe Anne can visit us instead.
Chapter 11. Devon. The hospital's exit led to a broad hallway. At least 16 different passages merged at this location. You could see at least 10 additional levels. A large translucent room that allowed in the light. Humans left the hospital and walked toward the middle of the park in front of it. Stephen noted the body language of his empress, which barely screamed rage, even from underneath her cloak.
Why do I get the impression that it's just personal?
Well, you don't see that very often, do you?
Space between them and anyone else, allowing him a better chance to watch everyone.
Stephen, a seed to cross their mental connection. He wasn't trying to steal any secrets. They went after him because Nathan ate with him one time, so they assumed he was special.
Wait. Truth doesn't have to be verified if they have a good guess.
He laughed as they beat the shit out of him.
She turned to face Stephen. Some of her white hair spilled from her cloak, and her eyes burned a dark red. Apparently, they were the hired toughs of some other company here on this world. They were cleaning up the suspected narcs. Once Chaito was tagged with Nathan, he was used as bait to bring Nathan here.
To do what?
Kill him, Bethany Ann stated. They have enough firepower, or believe they do, to take him out as well as his group.
How would hired toughs know enough to take out Nathan? He is a damned precolleach, as is his wife.
Mate.
Whatever. His family. Plus he has Bastak, a Yalin mercenary, and 2 Shrilexians.
It doesn't mean he would bring them all down here at the same time, she replied, looking around the park. This planet isn't going to be big enough for these assholes to get away, Stephen. Stephen sighed and took a look around himself before saying aloud in English.
I hope they have a large enough backhoe on this planet.
Bethany Ann pulled up a map of the city on her HUD. She stepped back onto the path and headed toward passageway DHE-668. They have valleys, so all we have to do is use some explosives to bring the dirt down on top of the dead bodies, she said as she walked out of the park. It will be easier that way.
Fucking hell,
Stephen groaned.
I haven't found a decent pizza place in this city yet.
He caught up with Bethany Ann and noticed that everyone got out of her way. Even with her figure hidden, she still unleashed a serious vibe of get the fuck away from me.
Well, shit.
He saw a Shrilexian turn the corner 2 hallways ahead as he noticed the small figure stomping toward him.
Shinigami, Steven sub-vocalized. Here, the EI responded. Please record my HUD video from now until we are finished with this operation.
Certainly, Steven. Should I tag this with any importance?
No, not at this time,
Steven responded.
Just Baba Yaga antics 101 for now.
Understood, the EI responded, and cut their connection. Steven noticed the small red dot off to the right in his HUD. The Shrilexian lowered his shoulder just a bit, and leaned forward the last two steps toward Bethany Ann.
Ouch,
he murmured. Bethany Ann didn't play nice. She ramped up her speed and bitch-slapped the side of the Shrilexian's head with her right hand while sweeping with her leg to knock his feet out from underneath him. She turned clockwise, looking over her right shoulder as she brought her fist around so quickly she was able to catch his forehead with her knuckles before he fell. The crack was louder than the subsequent thump of the alien's heavy body hitting the ground. Steven stepped over the large alien body as his empress continued walking. Neither she nor the Shrilexian had said a word to each other.
Feeling better? He sent.
Why? Putting a bully in his place was just a light snack. I need answers. I have Shinigami working on digging into the databases of the government. Hold out a chair across from Tina.
Have a pretty efficient way to handle that issue already.
As he said, her eyes narrowed in concentration. Nope. R2 says he can't find any history on the topic.
You were looking in the wrong area.
That didn't take long.
He reached out to grab the little red...
Of course.